Hello everyone, thanks for joining me in the Allen Block Workshop to learn about what it takes to successfully construct your Allen Block retaining wall project. What I will walk you through today are the steps you're going to take when constructing a reinforced wall. This is a retaining wall that needs geogrid within the wall structure to create additional stability, as the block weight is not enough to hold back the soil like a gravity wall. This video starts after you have properly installed, backfilled, and compacted your first course of block. This is shown in our base course in backfill and compaction videos. These are very important steps for proper retaining wall construction. So what is geogrid? Geogrid is a geosynthetic material used to reinforce soils. They typically come in large rolls and in a variety of strengths and are strongest along the roll or machine direction and need to be cut to length. They are best suited for walls over 6 feet high. AB reinforcement grid is designed for walls up to 6 feet high. It comes in 3 and 4 foot rolls and is biaxial, which means it has the same strength in both directions and it can be simply rolled out along the wall. AB reinforcement grid, when needed, will be installed on every other course to the top of the wall starting at the first course. Check the project's approved plans and specifications to determine when it's needed and the placement. How you construct the wall will ensure it does not overturn, settle, or even bulge. So let's grab our tools and head out to the sandbox. This video starts where the base course is installed, leveled, and compacted for the straight wall application. From here, we will begin installing the first layer of AB reinforcement grid. Place the edge of the grid against the back of the raised front lip and roll it out along the wall. If you need help or have curves and corners in your project, please refer to our installation manuals found on our website. These will also help to identify if your project does need reinforcement or can be built as a gravity wall. And it is always a good idea to check your local code requirements. When your approved plans recommend a stronger grid, it will be installed perpendicular to the block face and cut to the design length. Now, stack the next course of blocks on top of the geogrid and base course. Place the blocks so the bottom notch is tight against the front lip of the blocks below. Offset the blocks so the vertical seams are in a running bond pattern or are offset by at least a quarter of the block. Once the second course is in place, sight down the wall line to make sure the wall is straight and level. Adjust with a dead blow hammer as needed. Pull on the back of the grid to remove any slack. If necessary, stake it in place. You should never drive or compact directly on the reinforcement grid. This will damage the grid. Fill the hollow cores and 12 inches behind the block with wall rock. Use a flat nose shovel to remove the excess wall rock from the top of the blocks, then backfill behind the wall rock using approved on-site soils and rake smooth. Run a mechanical plate compactor over the top of the blocks, then in a path parallel to the wall, working from the back of the block to the back of the backfill area in 8-inch lifts or less. Make a minimum of 2 passes, keeping all heavy equipment at least 3 feet away from the back of the blocks. Remove any excess material from the top surface of the blocks and check for level and prepare a smooth surface for the next course. Repeat these steps to the top of your wall, and then add the geogrid reinforcement on every other course or as specified on the approved plans. So let's review what we have covered for building a reinforced retaining wall. You want to install your first layer of geogrid reinforcement directly behind the front lip of your base course. Then set the second course of blocks on the top of the base course with the bottom notch tight against the front lip. Remember to offset by at least a quarter of the block length. Sight down the wall and make any adjustments needed to ensure they are level and aligned. You will then fill the cores in 12 inches behind the wall with wall rock. Typically, on-site soils can be used behind the wall rock. Then, rake smooth and using a mechanical plate compactor, compact the entire area starting directly on top of the block and work into the backfill area. Make a minimum of 2 passes, keeping all heavy equipment at least 3 feet away from the back of the blocks. Sweep the top of the blocks clean and install the next course of blocks. Place wall rock in the block cores and behind the block, then the on-site soils behind the rock. Rake smooth with a shovel and run the compactor. Sweep clean to prepare for the next layer of geogrid. The success of a project will very often depend on the walls used during site development, which is one of the main reasons why we are focusing on proper construction. Reinforced retaining walls use geogrid reinforcement to provide the additional support needed for taller wall applications. These walls can range from small landscape walls that support a driveway to very large commercial walls that tower over the site and anything in between. By following this simple process, you will construct a proper reinforced wall that will provide the flat, buildable land you desire. For different wall applications and installation videos, visit us at allenblock.com. Happy building! Always better, always Allen Block.